Hey, what's going on, everybody? Red Rhino here, bringing you another video. Today, we're back on NASCAR Heat 5 to continue with our career mode. Today, we're doing an Xfinity race at Dover. We're finally out of that three-in-a-row Talladega race thing that we ended up getting in because they went there in real life. We did it for the Xfinity Series, and we did it for the Cup Series all in the same week. Too much Talladega, if you ask me. Today, we're going to Dover, though. We do have this incentive contract going. It's to get two top fives within five races. We already have one done from Talladega, and we have to get one more within the next four races. Dover might be the track to do it. It might not. Sometimes I do good here. Sometimes I do bad. I think the last time we came here, I did kind of bad, but that was also in the Cup Series, so it's a little different. The Xfinity Series is a little bit different of a car. Let's go ahead and go to the event. All right, guys, I went ahead and qualified. We're going to be starting in 16th. I am actually surprised we qualified that well because my time wasn't too close to pole. Pole was 23.7 or 24.2. In practice, yes, I skipped it there, but I was running practice a little bit before that, just kind of building out our tune here. And I was running a 24.0. I did kind of screw up the qualifier just a little bit, but we're still starting in a pretty good spot, so I'm not too worried. All right, so let's take a quick look at the setup. I'm actually kind of happy with it this time. So for shock settings, I don't really know what those numbers are. I just lowered everything by 2 or 4, I think. From what the default tune was, like I say every time, I don't know what that does. I gotta really read on it. Weight settings, the front weight I dialed a little bit to the back to help it turn in. I had trouble finding a sweet spot for that, so that is still in question, the front weight. Car does like to kind of steer down on its own at the exit of the turn when you start getting back in the throttle. Try to fix that through various different things, which I'll get into, but at the end of the day, it still kind of does it, so it's up to you, I guess, if you want to raise the front weight. Just know that the higher that number gets from where it is, the harder it is to turn. So I also tried running more front weight with less wedge, and then the opposite, less front weight with more wedge, and this is kind of where it was getting me the best time, so I left it here. Ride height's obviously as low as it gets. The springs, I softened up the right front, kind of get the car to turn in a little better, kind of plant itself, because that's kind of where the weight goes when you start turning. For the springs, I think they're at 900 and 800 and 350 and 450. I just kind of moved them around a little bit, just kind of get the car to be a little better. Tire pressures, I think the right front's actually default. I think they started out on the right side, that's 4750s. And the left sides were 18. Raised the left rear and the left front, and actually lowered the right rear just a little bit to give it a little more grip, because over here we're running a little bit higher of a track bar on the right side, and it tends to get you a little looser in the rear. So I kind of wanted to keep a little bit of grip in the rear without completely killing our ability to get the car to rotate. Camber is basically just where it is because that's where it is. I tried higher than that. I wasn't too happy with how it was turning in. It didn't feel good. It was having trouble turning in, so I just dialed it back a little bit. But the left front does tend to run a little cold. Sway bar, I tried raising that to counter the car wanting to turn in on its own, but anything higher than where it is, it starts bobbling around, and it starts to not turn in, so I left it here. The overall height of the track bar is pretty low to kind of keep the car not from drifting, but the right side is raised to kind of get it to turn a little better. Brake bias doesn't really matter because we're not going to be pitting, but if you are, you're going to want that to where you're comfortable for pit entry, so that's up to you. Roll tape, I was actually kind of a little torn between going to 35 or 40. I feel like 35 might help it handle a little better, but 40 is going to give us some speed, so I'd rather have a little bit of speed because I don't find the handling too bad. Wheel lock is just how much you want to steer, so the higher that number is, the more you have to turn your wheel. If you're not using a wheel, I don't really know how that works for you. I kind of like it at 12, and I don't like any steering offset. It always bothers me. I actually kind of prefer steering offset to be the opposite of what this game does. So negative turns to the left. This game only has negative, and positive turns to the right. I kind of like some positive. And all I did for the gear ratio was kind of stretch out the rear end a little bit just to kind of dull it down, because I was getting a little too fast into the throttle and having to correct it by getting out longer. And it's just easier to kind of kill the car down a little bit. So that's the setup. That out of the way, let's go ahead and start this race.
Two All right, you're coming to the green. Be ready.
All right, guys, here we go.
All right, let's go. Inside. Got a car low now.
Kind of have to back out of the throttle a little bit in the draft just because it was kind of pulling us, getting us a little too fast. It's the first time I really ran in the draft. I only drafted off a guy for a little bit in practice.
Still there. Got one inside.
Hill's getting loose from the little tiny bump I gave him. Seemed to have gotten it under control. We're going three wide. Three wide on the exit of these turns on Dover is very scary. We're getting moved around by the guy on the inside, trying to get out of the way of the guy on the outside. This is kind of what happens when you're surrounded by walls.
Two this time by. Inside.
Two laps to go this stage, see if we can get by this guy before the exit.
Clear high, bud.
Got by him, almost tapped the wall, actually. Got a little onto the apron there.
White flag is in the air.
It's kind of why I wish this game had positive steering offset.
Stay low.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Kind of hit all guy there coming out of that turn. I don't know if he went down or if I went too far up. But we're settling in for 15th, gained one spot. So I assume it's going to be like another four-lapper for stage two. And then whatever for stage three. We're not going to be pitting today. It looks like we're good on fuel. We only used up 2% of tires doing that little stage there, so I think we're all set.
Coming to the green, driver. Be ready.
Here we go.
Hold your line, got one outside.
Since the car does handle kind of funny in the draft, I would maybe put like an extra click or two of front weight towards the front, so raise it.
Clear high, bud.
Just because I feel like in the draft it's kind of pulling our car down even worse than it was in practice. But I am also probably just getting excited and heavy-footing this thing around since we're actually racing now.
Still there.
Because I know if I rolled this thing into the corner and then slow rolled it into the throttle like this, it was very good. It was pretty good there. Kind of tightened up under draft.
Careful, still there.
So who knows? Maybe it's just me. This is a hard track to pass on, though. We don't really have anything for the outside. We could get around people, or at least stick with them, but then there's always a worry if there's a guy up there. We don't really have room to get out of the turn.
All right, clear low. All clear. Two this time by. All clear.
So hard to pass here. We're having like a two-lap battle just with this guy to try to get by him.
Stay low, stay low.
We'll get by him now.
Right, you're clear. Last lap, hit your mark.
Touch that apron a little bit. It's actually not terribly dangerous on this track. But what it can do is if you stay in the throttle when you do it, it's going to drive you all the way up the track, and then you're most likely going to hit the wall if you stay in it. So I did it there. I had to back out a little bit, and we still even almost hit the wall. All right, so we're just outside the top 10. This isn't great for us for points. We're kind of just struggling to get by people. It's a tight track. It's kind of awkward to pass on. All right, so we got 16 laps for this stage, basically around double what we just ran for the first two combined. So we have plenty of time to work. Tires are gonna get hot, I assume, if they're not already. They're not terrible right now. They're actually pretty good in like the sweet spot. I would say. Right rear's a little hot. That's just because we're kind of whipping this thing around a turn. See, it's just a weird track to tune for. I always struggle at this track with tunes, I would say. Because it's either too loose or too tight at the same time in the same lap.
Alright, you're clear.
I think that's why I kind of have to start actually learning how to do suspension. I just have to, like, sit down one day and read. And figure it out.
Car outside. All clear. Alright, you're clear.
So whenever the next Heat game comes out, or whatever the next NASCAR game is, I kind of want to do setup videos for you guys, just like, specifically setups. So I know not everybody wants to watch my career stuff or whatever, or anything like that. Maybe they're just interested in the setups. So, that'd be kind of a good way to take care of that. Plus it would kind of shorten up these videos, because I wouldn't have to go over the setups and why I do what. It would be its own dedicated thing. But I do feel like it's a little too late to start getting into that for this game. There's plenty of setups out there.
Careful, still there.
I just kind of explain it as part of this video. Alright, so we're in our goal position. Anything in front of us is just a treat. Anything behind us is sadness. So, we gotta defend here. Gregson looks pretty fast. He caught up to us. I don't know how fast he caught up to us. I just caught him in my mirror there. He keeps diving to the inside, so it looks like he's trying to make something work. There he is. Good thing he kind of checked up, because we were completely loose.
You're all clear on the bottom.
Alright, P3 and 4 running the fence.
Got a car low now. Clear low, bud. Excellent lap. Good job.
7 to go. Just trying to focus. Get some good laps in. I am noticing that I'm giving it too much throttle. I need to just slow roll into it. It's kind of a habit of mine. Just giving it too much throttle. From what I understand, you're technically, I mean, you could do whatever you want, but I think you're technically not supposed to go flat out until you can see the straight. So I think you're supposed to be here, go 3/4 or half, whatever it takes, and then you open it up once you see the straight. And it does help you be smooth, it does help you save tires, but I think there's some exceptions to that, because for sure you're flat out all the time on super speedways. But even like a regular speedway, I think you could go flat out for a lot of it. Or even early in the turns. But I think for a track like this, where it's kind of like a perfect oval, rather than a speedway type shape, I think this helps.
Got a car low now.
I think in real life, the guys, do what they call double apexing, so like you go down in the beginning of the turn, rise up a little bit, and then come down again. Looks like Briscoe's kind of doing it a little bit. That's definitely something you do. I don't have enough control in this game, I would say, to do that. It's kind of like a wrestling match with the car a little bit, as far as being too tight. But if you could somehow do it,
inside.
It's probably not a bad idea.
2 laps to go. Bottom's clear. Inside. Hard from the outside. Outside.
Gregson kind of set us up there for a little bit of a problem. He kind of dove under us, and we had Briscoe and Annette on the outside. What's going on here?
Still there. Car outside.
Hard on the brakes. They just ate it.
Outside.
I don't know what's wrong with the cautions in Xfinity. Cup doesn't really do this for us. Some reason in the Xfinity career, though, they just don't call cautions. I have it set to relax, so it takes more than one car, but there's definitely more than one car there. There's two cars there when we got there, and then they all ran into it. Well, we're coming around to the end. Looks like we're going to be settling in for third.
Almost over the moon with the top five finish.
Never heard that one before. Almost over the moon with the top five finish. Never heard that. I'll take it, though. Third's not bad. We hit our goal position. That means we get that check at the end of the five races or whatever. We got three more to go after this. Apparently, to upgrade our car more than I have already, it's going to be like $5 or $6 million or something to completely finish it, so we're gonna have to work on that. We're gonna need a lot of money. So with that being the price tag, any little bit of amount of money helps us out. Alright, so for our race earnings, we finished in third. That gets us $102,000. Got a sponsor payout of $17,000 and a merch payout of $38,000. Bring us a total of $157,000. So that's pretty decent money. I feel like that's about average for what we're getting. It's kind of equal with what we're getting from Cup. We are in third in points. I think we just lost that spot to Cindric. Pretty sure he beat us there at the end. I think he was one of the guys in front of us. I don't quite remember. But yeah, we lost that spot to Cindric, so we're going to be looking to get that thing back. But we are far ahead in wins. I think we have the most wins out of everybody in the series. And we have the most playoff points as well. So that's good. We're looking good with that. Alright guys, so once again we finished third, got the $157,000, gained 5,000 fans, and somehow we had moderate driving and average savings. That puts our car back to 75. I think if it goes down to 70, that's considered what needs to be repaired. I'm not too sure. We do have two cars that need repair, so we'll take a look at that real quick. Actually, I don't even think we can. Gonna put us to the Cup Series thing. I know definitely our Super Speedway car and our Short Track car both need repairs. So we're going to have to repair those. I don't think that Speedway car will need it. I think next time for Xfinity, we're going to Charlotte and then Mid-Ohio. I don't know Mid-Ohio at all. I've never raced there, so that's kind of what I'm worried about. But we do have that incentive contract out of the way now, so I don't really care. Whatever we get to that is whatever we get. Looks like we're going to be going back to Dover with the Cup Series car for Wednesday's career race video. So that's what's going on with that. Looks like we're in fourth for the Cup Series, and we're 20 points behind Kyle Busch, so we're going to look to kind of cut down that lead, I guess. Anyways, guys, that's about it for this one. If you like seeing NASCAR Heat 5 on the channel, make sure you hit that like button down below, and if you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button as well, so you can get notifications for when I upload new videos. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. See y'all next time. Peace.